Today we learn chapter 3, transformation problem solving. I will choose one question from the problem solving, that's question 7a. 今天我们学 chapter 3, transformation 3, 来到 problem solving, 老师只选一题，就是第七题的 A. Okay. 7a, in the diagram above, A prime is the image of A under a transformation P, and A prime prime is the image of A prime under a transformation Q. So, 我把这一个句子把它 summarize 变成一个图。I summarize this sentence into a diagram. So, from A go to A prime, from A prime go to A prime prime.A prime is the image of A under transformation Q. So I know A go to A prime is under transformation Q. And A prime go to A prime prime is under transformation Q. Okay, question 1. Describe in full the transformation P and Q. So before we go to describe the full sentence, so we...recall back, 我们回忆一下 We have 4 transformation, 我们一共有四种的 transformation. Okay, we see A go to A prime. Is it a translation? No. Translation, the shape and the direction must be the same. 如果这个是 translation 的话，它的形状跟它的方向一定是一样的，所以这个不是 translation. Is it a rotation?Okay, we go to, is it a reflection? 这个是反射吗？像镜子这样子吗？ No, if this is a reflection, the diagram should be like this. It will opposite, 它会像反方向这样子的方向。So this is not reflection. Okay, we go to ask, is it enlargement? No, this is no enlargement. Enlargement should be the shape is bigger and the direction should be the same. So this is not enlargement. So we know this is rotation. So we just jot down, this is rotation. 我们就先把 rotation 写下来。Okay, A prime go to A prime prime.Okay, so this is very easy to recognize. 这个是非常容易认的，因为它变大了。So this is should be enlargement. 这个一定是 enlargement. So rotation, the sentence you need to memorize. This is transformation P. So P is a what rotation? Clockwise or anti-clockwise? 我们有顺时跟逆时的。Rotation. 所以呢，这里应该要填 clockwise or anti-clockwise of how many degree? Either is 90 degree or 180 degree. We have two angles only. About the center, what center we need to determine? Enlargement. Q is an enlargement of, so you need to give me, if this is enlargement, you need to give me scale factor and with center.What? Okay, this is the sentence you need to know how to write in full sentence. So now we go to see how to find the center of the rotation. 我们怎样去找那个 center rotation 呢? So I can use the L-shaped ruler. 我会选 L-shaped ruler to try an arrow. Okay, so I use an L-shaped ruler. I choose this corresponding point. 我选这个 corresponding point. You must choose the corresponding point, try and error. So when you use L-shaped ruler, you will see that if this is the center of the rotation, the distance from here is 2.5. And the distance from this point go to the center must be 2.5 or so. So,then this point only can say is the center of the rotation. You can try with another corresponding point. For example, you can try this point and this point with the L-shaped ruler. Is it still same distance if this is the center? Okay, 你可以再，如果你不相信你的答案，你可以再用这个 corresponding point 去试一下用你的长度 okay, 用你的尺去放在这个的 center 去量一下，到底这个是不是跟它同等的。所以如果是同等的长度呢，那么它就是我们的 center。 So I know this is the center of the rotation. So I just draw two lines. 我就会画两条线。So I can see that this is 90 degree. 我会发现这里是90度。 So I know this is 90 degree. Okay, so A one go to A prime, A 要去变成 A prime 是这个方向，90度是这个方向。 So is this direction, this is our clock. So I, the clock is turned this way. So this is clockwise. 所以这个是 clockwise. Okay, so I know this is clockwise. So what is the center over here? 这个 center 是什么？从 X 开始读。 So it's at and to. So P is a clockwise rotation of 90 degree about the center at 2. Okay, now we go to this one. A prime go to A prime prime. I know this is enlargement. The most important thing is I want to find the center of the enlargement. 所以我要知道的 center 在哪里。 So I know this is the corresponding point. This is the corresponding point. This point is the corresponding point. So I just use a ruler connect the corresponding point. 我就用尺去画 corresponding point. Then the intersection is the center of the enlargement. 两条线或者更多线碰在一起的中那一个 intersection 呢，叫做 center of the enlargement. 所以呢，这个是我们的 center of the enlargement. 所以呢，我们就知道我们的 center 是2跟 3, 这个是 2, 这里是 3, 所以我们的 center 是2跟 3. 可是我的 scale factor 怎么算呢？还记得怎么算 scale factor 吗？ scale factor 就是上面是我们的 image 的 length, the upper side is the length of the image, the lower is the length of the object. So I choose this length, so this isImage, so 1, 2, 3, 4, so 4. Object is 1 and 2, so this is 2, so the scale factor is 2. Or you can choose this length also. Again, yes, 可以选 this length and the corresponding length is this one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so 6. 1, 2, 3.So still the same is equal to 2, 还是一样拿到2. So scale factor is 2 with the center is 2 and 3. Just now I used the L-shaped ruler to try and error. Now I demonstrate I use the compasses. 刚才我是用 L-shaped 的词来去 try and error 去找它的 center. 现在呢我就用compasses, 其实我会也很喜欢用 compasses, 因为 compasses 就很能够直接的找出答案，不需要 try and error. Okay, so the first thing we need to determine the corresponding point. So this is the corresponding point. This point is the corresponding point. This point is the corresponding point. So I choose corresponding point. So first, I choose this.Okay, I skip this one because I discussed. So I choose this point. I draw the arc up and down. After that, the corresponding point is this. Okay, so your compasses move to corresponding point up and down. Remember, don't move your compasses. 选两个 corresponding point. 做你的 compasses up and down. 然后记得不要移动你的 compasses.Okay, so I draw a one straight line using a ruler. 我就用一把尺连接这个两个点。After that, I go to choose another corresponding point. So I choose this point. I draw up and down using the compasses. Okay, 同样的 this is the corresponding point. So I draw up and down. So got two point, 有两个点了，所以可以用尺连起来。Got two point, then you can connect with a ruler. So this is the intersection point. Intersection point is our center of the rotation. 两个线接在一起的，这个就是它的 center. So the center is at and through. So I just Choose a corresponding point, draw a straight line. Okay, so 这个是 corresponding point 是不是? 所以就画这个线去它的 center. So this is 90 degree. And from A to A prime, this is clockwise rotation. So clockwise rotation, 90 about the center at 2. Okay, so this is how I use the compasses to determine the center of the rotation. Okay, this, so this one I skip up. Okay, we look at 7A2. Given A represent a region of area 85. Okay, this one A is our object. The area is 85 cm squared. Calculate the area in cm square of the region represented by the shaded region. I want to find A prime prime. This one is 85. This one same. Same, so this is also 85. This is our object for our A prime prime, right? So area of image is equal to k square times area of object. So I know the area of object already. How about the k square? From the A1, we know the scale factor is 2. So the area of image is equal to scale factor square times the area of the object. This is our object. So is 340. This is A3. A prime prime is the image of A under a combined transformation. State the combined transformation. Actually, this one just combine these two sentences only. 只是把这两个 sentence 放在一起. Okay, so A prime prime is an image of A under step 1 is P, step 2 is Q, under a clockwise rotation of 90 degrees, copy back, then followed by an enlargement of center. So we just combine the sentence only. So that's all for this question.